Mars was once considered a geologically dead planet that is smaller than Earth and that loses its internal heat more quickly. Back in the day, Mars had a lot of volcanic activity, and signs of massive eruptions are still visible on its surface. Anyhow, these volcanic eruptions stopped a long time ago, because the planet's core cooled down and solidified. The cooling of the planet led to a weaker magnetic field on Mars, which in turn let solar winds erode its atmosphere and turn the leftover water into ice. Recent discoveries suggest, though, that Mars is not completely dead from a geological point of view. Astronomers have studied thousands of pictures of Mars's equatorial region taken by NASA's HiRes camera on a Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter from 2006 to 2020. These photos show many landslides and debris flows on Martian volcanoes, as well as more than 4,500 tracks of rocks leaving patterns that look like Christmas trees, usually formed after strong earthquakes. The longest tracks stretch for 2.4 kilometers, and the overall length of all tracks was around 900 kilometers. About a third of these tracks were not in pictures taken before 2006, meaning they formed later. Only powerful underground movements could move such large rocks, but until recently, these kinds of movements were not detected on Mars. An innovative study published in Nature Astronomy in December 2022 showed that a huge column of hot material, known as a mantle plume, is pushing up against the Martian crust from below. This pressure is causing the surface to crack and is leading to tectonic activity. Mars used to be a planet with a high level of volcanism, and ancient mounds like Mount Olympus still remain on its surface. Mount Olympus has a diameter of over 600 kilometers and a height of 21 kilometers. It's the tallest mountain and volcano in the solar system, and you can even see it with an amateur telescope from Earth. High-resolution images from a spacecraft orbiting Mars show a lot of cracks and dark streaks of material rich in volcanic minerals, called pyroxenes, in the Cerberus foci area. Amazingly, these flows could have happened just tens of thousands of years ago, indicating continued movement below the surface. In addition, the InSight lander from NASA, which touched down in the Elysium Planitia region in 2018, recorded numerous minor and several moderate Mars quakes. It seems that most of these Mars quakes came from the direction of Cerberus foci, suggesting that the mantle of Mars could still be active. Computer models that mimic Mars's geophysics propose that a mantle plume, which is from 95 to 2085 degrees Celsius hotter and slightly less dense than the surrounding mantle, could clarify the odd features in Cerberus foci. This plume, located almost directly beneath the pits, is thought to have started its activity about 350 million years ago, long after most other significant geological activity on Mars had stopped. While there are also other explanations, the idea of a mantle plume accounts for most of the observed phenomena. If this hypothesis is true, it could have important implications for our understanding of Mars's interior and the potential for life on Mars. A heated mantle plume might warm water reserves enough to turn them into liquid, which is essential for the kind of life we are familiar with on Earth. Therefore, researchers are now able to explore the idea that life could exist far beneath Mars's surface. What factors helped researchers discover that Mars has become active? How is it that recent samples collected from a single crater showed almost no signs of life? And how could the detection of geological activity on Mars affect future missions aimed at exploring and colonizing the Red Planet? You are watching the Homo Deus channel. Here we talk about science and technology and reflect on the future ahead of us. Subscribe to the channel and join us on this journey as we expand our understanding of space and push the boundaries of our own little world. Since being sent into space in 2018, the InSight spacecraft has been tracking Martian seismic activity using its seismic experiment for interior structure. It has recorded over 1,300 quakes, a figure that is much smaller than what's observed on Earth, where seismometers pick up between 500,000 to 1 million earthquakes a year. Also, most of Mars's seismic vibrations are weak, with magnitudes up to 3. The strongest quake with a magnitude of 4.2 was recorded in August 2021, followed by a 5-magnitude Mars quake in May 2022. On Earth, such an event would only result in broken windows and minor infrastructure damage, but for Mars it was a big deal. Earthquakes on our planet are more intense because of the movement of tectonic plates and volcanic eruptions. Compared to Earth, Mars is less active, but quakes with a magnitude of 5 suggest that tectonic processes are still happening beneath the surface. Shifts in magma eruptions continue, and as magma rises, it bends Mars's single lithospheric plate, causing earthquakes. Could geological activity on Mars help us solve the mystery of life on it? Even though Mars has a severe and unfriendly environment with extreme cold, dangerous radiation, and lack of liquid water, we still wonder if life can be found on the red planet. While big creatures such as giraffes, cats, or even hamsters wouldn't be able to survive the extreme conditions on Mars and would be easily spotted by telescopes or rovers if they would, tiny life forms such as microorganisms could potentially endure such environments and go unnoticed. It has been found that microbes can survive in extreme conditions on Earth, which suggests that they might also exist on Mars, especially in its warmer depths that are shielded from deadly radiation. The finding of subterranean lakes on Mars is fascinating, as it points to the existence of liquid water, which is crucial for life as we understand it. In 2018, radar equipment on the Mars Express spacecraft orbiting the planet found a large underground lake near the south pole of Mars, along with three smaller water bodies nearby. These lakes take up more than 75,000 square kilometers in a big icy flat area called Plenum Australe. In 2022, instruments on the ExoMars orbiter detected huge amounts of frozen or liquid water in the canyons of Mariner Valley, hidden in a canyon system that runs along the planet's equator. The water in these canyons covers an area about the size of the Netherlands and is located just below the surface of Mars, in the top 3 feet of soil. We found that microbes, fish, and other organisms live in the subglacial lakes of Antarctica on Earth, and this could also be true for Mars. While some heat from Mars's core stays below the surface, it might not be enough to melt the ice. So, these lakes could be frozen because of high salt levels. If the salt level is 20 or more times higher than in Earth's oceans, it would be hard to survive even for microbes. To clarify this, scientists are trying to figure out what's in the underground lake's water, and are also looking for signs of life in dried-up surface ponds. Mars used to have lots of lakes and rivers, as well as a warmer climate and atmosphere that could support different forms of life. But until recently, no evidence had been discovered. In 2022, the Perseverance rover uncovered something remarkable. It found organic molecules near ancient sources of water. Even though it wasn't the first time a rover had found organic material on Mars, this finding was really important. It happened in an area where the old river system and lakes used to be, making it a place that would have been good for life. This area is in the Jezero crater, which is 45 kilometers wide. About 3.5 billion years ago, a delta formed here, collecting sand, mud, and salts over time. Perseverance was able to extract the most Martian organic molecules ever from this mix. What's interesting is that on Earth, rocks like these often have fossils of ancient creatures. The Perseverance rover's Sherlock device, built to detect organic and chemical compounds, examined molecules in the Jezero crater. Among other elements, it found hydrogen atoms bonded to carbon atoms. Carbon is crucial for life and may suggest the presence of life processes. It's important to mention that the organic molecules in the Jezero crater deposits are mixed with sulfates. On our planet, sulfate deposits preserve organic material and frequently show signs of past or present life. Nonetheless, the compounds in the crater might also be the result of non-biological processes. Researchers aim to pinpoint their source more precisely when the samples are brought back to Earth, which NASA plans to do soon. Meanwhile, researchers have found other clues that hint at the possibility of life on Mars. Not long ago, the Curiosity rover found surprisingly elevated methane concentrations on Mars, measuring 21 parts per billion in volume. This is important because on Earth, higher levels of methane are typically generated by living beings. Scientists plan to find out if the gas on Mars is connected to the activity of possible residents. If the methane had been produced a long time ago, it would have already broken down into its basic elements. Another option is that the gas formed through the contact between rocks and water. All of this sounds really exciting, but can it actually help us settle on Mars? Yes, methane isn't the only gas that's catching scientists' attention. Carbon dioxide, considered harmful on Earth, could soon become invaluable on the red planet. A toaster-sized experimental device called MOXIE was sent to Mars on board of the Perseverance rover. Its parts were 3D printed from a heat-resistant nickel-based alloy. The device also includes a lightweight aerogel to trap heat and a thin outer layer of gold to reflect infrared radiation. Thanks to these innovative features, the device can withstand temperatures of up to 800 degrees Celsius, needed for the gas conversion process. The MOXIE device recently created pure oxygen from CO2 by separating the oxygen atoms from the CO2 molecules and releasing carbon monoxide as a byproduct. Designed to produce up to 10 grams of oxygen per hour, the device made about 5.4 grams in its first hour-long test. That's enough for an astronaut to breathe for around 10 minutes. MOXIE is particularly valuable because it uses an almost endless supply of raw material. Mars's atmosphere is 96% carbon dioxide. In addition, MOXIE can use the regolith, the soil that covers Mars's surface. This soil can be turned into fuel, air we breathe, or even water when combined with hydrogen. Both NASA and SpaceX CEO Elon Musk are keenly interested in the scientific discoveries being made on Mars. Musk is actively preparing for missions and has promised that astronauts will set foot on Mars by 2029. SpaceX has already conducted initial tests of its Starship rocket, the heaviest rocket ever built. Additionally, NASA has chosen Starship as the first crewed lunar lander. If everything goes as planned, astronauts will land on the Moon between 2025 and 2027 as part of the Artemis 3 mission. By 2040, NASA has plans to launch a crewed mission to Mars, aiming to create a lasting human settlement on the red planet. This bold initiative will require tackling numerous obstacles, including developing technologies to generate and store energy, maintain life support systems, and supply essential resources like water, air, and food. One possible solution to these challenges is the concept of in-situ resource utilization, or ISRU. By taking advantage of what's already on Mars, colonizers of the future can reduce the amount of supplies they need to bring from Earth, which will significantly cut down both costs and risks of the project. The effective performance of MOXIE device, which made oxygen from Martian carbon dioxide, is a great example of how ISRU could work. In addition, advancements in space farming and self-sustaining life support systems will be crucial for long-term missions and possible colonization. Scientists are now testing different types of plants and cultivation techniques to find the best ways to produce food in Martian conditions. For example, NASA's veggie experiment on the ISS has tested growing lettuce, radishes, and wheat in microgravity. This knowledge will sure be significant for keeping people alive on Mars. Also, radiation protection is a big concern for astronauts going on long space missions. Mars has a sparse atmosphere that provides only minimal protection from destructive cosmic radiation. Therefore, researchers are looking into new materials and building methods to create radiation-safe living spaces. They are also developing advanced spacesuits that can provide enough protection while activities are carried out on the surface. In summary, the finding of organic compounds and MOXIE's effective performance on Mars have brought us nearer to grasping the possibilities Mars offers for life and human missions. As NASA and SpaceX keep pushing forward with their bold plans to send humans to the Moon and Mars, new scientific discoveries and tech innovations will lay the groundwork for long-term human settlement on these celestial bodies. The exploration of Mars is just getting started, and the future years hold the potential for thrilling finds and accomplishments as we aim to study and colonize the Red Planet. Thanks for your attention. Your engagement is really valuable to us. Please follow our channel and let us know in the comments if you believe life will ever be found on Mars and if you'd like to be among the first ones to colonize the Red Planet. We're eager to hear your thoughts. As Thomas Berger once said, the art and science of asking questions is the source of all knowledge.